Now, in this question, a lot of people make a mistake about thinking that the factors that affect equilibrium have the same effect on rate. Sometimes the factor can change the equilibrium direction, but still affect rate differently. For example, generally, if you increase anything, for example, I'm just going to talk about this, but if you look at the Haber's process, which is N2 plus 3H2 becoming 2 moles of ammonia, and delta H is minus something, so it's exothermic, right? So if I increase pressure, there will be a different effect on rate and a different effect on equilibrium. Rate ka effect wahi hoga jo aapne O levels mein padha, without even thinking about equilibrium. If you increase pressure of a system which is equilibrium, which is gases ka, then pressure increases will increase the rate of reaction, which means it will increase the rate of both the forward reaction and backward reaction. Rate, not position, rate. But the position will depend on the equilibrium. Here, if I increase pressure, what will the equilibrium want to do? Decrease pressure. It will go to the side where there are fewer moles of gas. That is which side?
Right.
So even if it's going forward, that's an equilibrium shift. The rate of both the forward and the backward will increase. Even though the equilibrium is shifting forward, people assume that that also means the rate of forward increases but not backward. It can't be that case, because equilibrium means the rate of the forward and the backward will eventually become equal. That's what equilibrium is. So even if it shifts to the right, it will make a new equilibrium. Wherever it was, it will now be a new equilibrium. And that equilibrium, the rate of the forward and the backward will be faster because you increase pressure. The same applies to temperature. Isme, if you increase the temperature, the equilibrium position will go to the endothermic side, which is backward. But by increasing temperature, what happens to the rate? Rate for both forward and backward will increase. So even though it is shifting backwards, the rate of the forward and the backward will increase. Here, they're talking about, assuming the amount of catalyst remains constant, that question might be different from this, but I'm just going to put that out there, what I just said. So what will not bring about a increase in rate? Pressure, temperature, catalyst, they all increase rate. So that's why the answer would have to be D. Even though decreasing the catalyst will lower the rate, increasing pressure will shift to the right, increasing temperature shift to the left. But they all increase the rate, forward and backward. People take this to mean, oh, if it's going backwards, that means backward is increasing, not forwards. Or did you size of catalyst? Pieces, yeah, sorry. I thought they meant total amount of catalyst. A will increase the rate of reaction, yes. So, can I go forward then? Okay. Now, they're saying two experiments together by anhydrous potassium chloride. Chloride ne pehle kya dala? Sulfuric acid. So chloride plus sulfuric acid makes what? HCl. And there is no oxidation, guys. Then the fumes produce a bubble through. So fumes are HCl. HCl Ki will have no reaction. You know why? Because both are anions. Anions can't react. It has to be the unless this was potassium bromide. Because if it was potassium bromide, then bromide plus sulfuric acid will give you bromine gas. That is redox. This is group 17 theory of sulfuric acid. Okay, with which does considered sulfuric acid give redox and not? With chloride, there is no redox. It's simple displacement. So you make HCl. With bromide and iodide of sulfuric acid. People confuse sulfuric acid being added to iodide here. Sulfuric acid is being added to a chloride, which is not an iodide. If it was an iodide, the fumes would be iodine. Here it is chloride, the fumes are HCl. And HCl when passed through potassium iodide will have no reaction. If chlorine was passed through potassium iodide, there would be a reaction. Meaning they would give me iodine and that would be brown. But yeh nahi ho raha, toh answer would be C or D. It have to be colorless. And then when you add aqueous ammonia, and then you add silver nitrate, what do you think you're going to get? You're going to get a white PPT if there was no ammonia. Because silver nitrate and chloride makes a white PPT. But you already have ammonia present. And you know what happens to that white PPT in ammonia? It dissolves. So, that's why the answer would be C. Isme, the same number of unpaired electrons. And what people don't realize is that when someone starts solving this question, they just start looking for same number of P electrons. Because the assumption is, if the number of P electrons are the same, that means unpaired are the same. For example, if P electrons are 1, unpaired is 1. If P is 2, unpaired are 2. If P is 3, unpaired are 3. If P is 4, unpaired are 2. And that's the thing that people forget. And that you see in F plus. F is in group 17. The plus would, the outer ones would have 7 electrons, which would mean it's P5. But F plus makes it what? P4. So how many unpaired here? 2 unpaired. Gallium is group 3. It's supposed to be P3. But minus means gain 1 electrons, so it becomes P2. So P1, P2. So 2 unpaired, and a lot of people miss out option number 2. That's why this is a problem. What about option 1?
Option 1
with the unpaired electrons. No, I'm pointing out the most common problem people have. So if 2 is right, by the way, in such questions, if 2 is right, I'm just pointing out most of people had problem with 2. You would already have gone through 1 to get 2 through. You should do this in sequence of the order, not look at 3 and then 2 and then 1. So I know 1 is because this is group 17, group 7, 16 or group 6, outermost 6 hai, wo group 7 hai, 1 lost, 6, so wahan to same ho gaya na. Nobody has a problem when the number of P's is the same. The problem was when the P's are not the same, but the unpaired is still the same. Yahan P mein 2 hai, yahan P mein 4 hai. And that's what people don't realize, that even P2 and P4 mein unpaired P are the same. So I would assume that everybody could get option number 1 correct. Then I would move on to 2. Now, one plant change the atmospheric pressure from 1 to 20 atm. Obviously, if you have to generate higher pressure, you have to generate more fuel, you have to use up more fuel. If you're using up more fuel, obviously the cost will increase. Okay? Then, and look at the equilibrium. So, at a higher pressure, the equilibrium will shift to the side which is less molar coverage. In this case, that's the right hand side. So it will increase SO3's production. And this was the same point I was making in question number 1. Even though it's going right, that has nothing to do with rate. Rate ke liye, if you increase pressure, the rate of reaction will increase. And people found this to be a problem. That's what I'm trying to say, that even if the reaction is going forward, the rate of forward and backward will increase if a factor will increase rate. In this case, higher pressure will increase rate. So both the rate of the forward and backward will increase. And you can learn it. Rate is independent of equilibrium position. And if any factor increases one side ka rate, then the other side ka rate will also increase. You can't increase the rate of forward reaction while not increasing the rate of the backward reaction. It is impossible. So now a number of alcohols are oxidized separately. 70 grams produce a yield of, this is simple actually mathematics. You first find the MR of this compound. I believe that's 74, right? I think, I'm just guessing. Like I said, I thought you guys told me that you've done the question. So you would have the MR somewhere, right? No? Okay, so.
74.
So that you guys were lying to me in Ramzan. So this is the number of moles of the alcohol. And then, This has to have a 62% yield. So what's the moles of product at a 62% yield of the moles of the reactant? Because if there was yield 100%, the mole ratio would be 1:1. But they're saying the yield is 62%. So how many come? Somebody give me an actual value. No. 62% or 62 over 100 into 70 over 74. 0.6054 moles. Ab aapko ye check karna hai ki 0.605 moles of butanone would it give me this much mass? Or 0.64 moles of 0.6054 of butanoic acid? And then you have to find the MR of these first. ठीक है एंड नो लिटरली दैट इज द क्वारी फॉर ईच पार्ट के लिए यू गॉट टेक पॉइंट 0.5864 एंड इनटू द एमआरस ऑफ द अदर नाउ यू मस्ट रियलाइज दैट द ऑप्शन नंबर 2 and 3 आर आइसोमर्स उनके मास तो सेम होंगे MRs. So if 2 is correct, 3 is correct. If 2 is wrong, 3 is wrong because yahan bhi mass same hai donon ke. So find the MRs of these. That's what you have to do. Butanone ka MR kitna hai? Anybody have the answer for that? I think it's 72. You know actually how do I know that? Because H and OH, remember in alcohol oxidation mein, H and OH become C double bond O. So you're actually just losing out 2 H's. And then to become an acid, you become C double O, OH. So you minus 2 then, and then you add 16. Ye hota na? 16, 1 O. So 72 to 16 is 88. I mean, that's the fastest way of just finding out MR. And then solve and find out. Huh? Oh, okay. Yes, this is a trick question. People don't realize that 80% of air is nitrogen and it will not react with anything, it will stay as nitrogen. People miss that out. It's like a more trick question. 80% of air is nitrogen. None of it will react. The bakaya, let's say the rest of the air is how much? Nitrogen is 80%. Baki sab kitna hua? 20%. Let's say it all becomes shit. Whatever the hell you want it to become. Whatever it becomes, let's say it becomes carbon dioxide. So now how much carbon dioxide do I have? How much nitrogen do I have? Which is more? Now, guys, the biggest problem here, what people don't realize in this question is, when it says which combination of compounds can be obtained, people try to break one of this into all of these at one go. That's not what they're asking. They're asking, can any one of this become any of this at any point? And if you look at this question, how many carbons does it have? No. 8. This has 8 carbons, right? So it can break down into anything less than 9 carbons. Isme kitne hain? 2. Isme hain 3. Isme hain 3. Isme hain 4. So all power possible. How can all be possible? Well, they can make this with a 4 carbon alkane. They're not saying ye sab ek saath bane hain. Impossible होता साथ बने होंगे ये है कि possible combinations कौन सी हैं this with butane could be possible this with pentadiene is possible this with pentene is possible and this with मतलब इसमें दो हैं तो the other guy would have 6 carbons and a double bond this is 3 carbons other guy would have 5 carbons and a double bond three carbons, the other guy would have five bonds and two double bonds. Because your parasy ek hai. The point here is that, understand two things. Any combination of products can be formed as long as the maximum number is not reached, which is the maximum number of carbon atoms in a molecule. Yahan char hai, iske andar eight hai. Nothing is bigger than eight here. So all are possible. And that's why the answer is A. Okay, so I love this question because you have to work with this backwards. They're making this by adding ammonia to something. Ammonia is NH3. But if I look at the structure, I have just NNH. And by adding NH3, what am I giving up? Huh? Two HBRs. But jahan laga hua hai, wo NH laga hua hai. But NH3 laga tha maine. So, two H to HBR mein chale gaye. Aur ek H yahan laga hai. Which means that, isko nikalna hoga mujhe. Aur yahan ek BR hoga, aur yahan ek BR hoga. That would have been most likely what was the compound was. Kyun? Because, that's what they're saying, for each NH3, I'm getting two HBRs. So I remove the NH3, which already know NH, and the two H's will make NH3. Bagi bacha BR, BR, so I put BR here and BR here. And when I do that, this no longer becomes cyclic. And then I start counting from the left, position number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's 1,5 dibromo. And how many carbon atoms? 5, 6, 7, 8. Octane. Hence the answer would have been delta. Now, silver chloride dissolves in this process. It is this reaction, AgCl plus two ammonias become this complex ion that I've told you to rectify. This is sorry. And a coordination bond is formed. The oxidation number is unchanged. Now what is a coordinate bond? It's a dative bond. And how do you know dative bonding is formed? Well, it's not in your AS syllabus, but this is what it is. And actually, you know what? I didn't have a chance to remove some of the old syllabus questions from here. So, ek do might pop up. Especially electrolysis ke bhi honge. It's no longer in the syllabus, but I didn't remove it from these worksheets. I forgot. I just realized right now, looking at this, that I must have not done that also. So this is a complex ion, that's the dative bond. But a bronsted base has to do what? Accept what? H plus. There is no H plus involved here, proton. So it cannot be a bronsted base. So three is wrong. Okay, so now how many isomeric esters have the molecule C4H8O2? Always assume and try to make the maximum number. See if that's possible. But ester ke liye, what do you need? You need COC. COOC. And then I'll make 5. And see if I can make 5 different ones. Our total carbons kitne hain? 4. So one process is start with 1 carbon on the alcohol and 3 carbons on the acid. That makes it 4. Or 2 carbons on the alcohol, 2 carbons on the acid. Or how much? 3 carbons on the and 1 carbon on the alcohol right there. But because now we have a 3 carbon alcohol can actually have a branched alcohol also. Like that. And you will realize that there are 4 possibilities. You can't make a 5th one. Yes, there would be other isomers, there would be acids, not esters. Because you went systematically from having the maximum number of carbons in an acid to the minimum number. There's nothing lower than one carbon acid. So here the answer would have to be C. Which graph such has does not have such a profile? This is a two-step, right? Which one is two-step? So which one doesn't have this? This is a two-step graph. Which type of reaction isn't two-step? SN2. So you have to look for SN2. This two-step reaction is for two-step reaction. I told you guys this, every organic mechanism is two-step. Free radical substitution, nucleophilic addition, nucleophilic substitution for tertiary. And electrophilic addition for alkenes. The only one that is not two-step is SN2. That is one step. And SN2 is for primary halogenoalkenes. And where are primary halogenoalkenes? In B. Therefore, because that is the only single step reaction, SN2. This is the question that is no longer in the syllabus. I am sorry I gave this. Please cross this out. It has been removed from the syllabus. Okay, next up, question number 13. When? This is a key, something that has a melting point of higher than room temperature, but a boiling point of lower than room temperature. Boiling point higher than room temperature and melting point lower than room temperature. That guy is a liquid. That's straight up correct. So X has to be bromine. And between such melting points, you realize that Y is from group 1. Group 1 is the only metal which can be less dense than water and have low melting points. So, that would be the case. Bravo. And this would be like it floats on water. So if you remember, something that has lower density than water will not sink in water. And the elements involved comparatively are only sodium and aluminum. So FYX, why would have to be that? Okay, now the reason why this question is good is because why people make a mistake on this is they assume that they have to take silver solid into the equation also. You do not. The KC expression for this reaction is Fe3 plus over Ag plus into Fe2 plus. You have to do the initial reacted final row, by the way, isn't it? Right? Yeah. Which would be what? Ag plus, Fe2 plus, and Fe3 plus. That's all I care about. Initial were how much? Ag ke the? 1, 1, 0. Reacted equilibrium. How much was that mixture and equilibrium point? So 0.56 reacted, and that would be in the ratio of the reaction. The reaction is 1:1:1. Is to 1. This would be point. So it will be 0.56 over 0.44 squared. And that will give you what answer? I don't know. I have no idea. 14 gives you what, guys? Huh? Delta? Yeah, this pen is a little light. That's all. There you go. Okay, moving on. Then, 2.76 grams of ethanol is mixed. How many moles is that? You got to find the MR of ethanol, which is 46. So how many moles is that? Huh? 0.06. It was, the reaction mixture was then boiled under reflux for an hour. People sometimes miss that out. They only see the part that it says distilled. So, what kind of product, what is the name of the product formed? If I ask you, what is the name of the product formed? It's a carboxylic acid, not an aldehyde. Why? Because we didn't immediately distill off the product. We let it boil for one bloody hour before we distill it off. Whatever the hell it was, it will have become an acid. Yeah, yeah. That's what people miss out on. So you got to make 0.06 moles of the acid. So acid ka mass kitna hai? So 0.06. MR is 60. That will give you 3.6 grams, I believe. But the yield has to be only how much? MR is 60 of the acid. I mean, you can calculate that, but I think it's 60. So 75% of 3.6 kitna aata? 2.7? So that's the closest answer. That is the closest answer. Because uska bhi kar sakte hain aapki marzi. Answer same aana. 75% of 0.06, then into MR kar doge to answer wahi aana. I did this way because theoretically this is how you do it, but mathematically the method is fine, nobody's checking the working, so why do you care? Okay. Reaction will not occur in treated oil? You see, the problem is that hydroxides, now in this particular case, why? But hydroxide and ammonium ion, this is a reaction of lab theory. If you remember, ammonium ions ka test kya hota hai? They give ammonia gas with NaOH. Kyu? Because hydroxide and ammonium ion give me ammonia and water. So, and where do I get ammonium from? From ammonium fertilizer and lime. So when they react together, they make ammonia. Ye to hoga hi hoga. Dusra, ammonium, the reason why do you spread lime on any fertilizer is because to reduce acidity, to reduce, it neutralizes H plus ions. Now, why does the reaction number 3 happen? A lot of people miss that out. Why does this happen? Because the jahan farmer plant kar raha hai, wo pode hote hai. Plants also breathe and give out what? Carbon dioxide. That carbon dioxide over time will have a reaction. Yes, you might say, well, sir, I take biology, I know there's photosynthesis also. Well, not in the evening. In the evening is just respiration. So, yeah. And this is, by the way, the lime water test. This is lime water. And he passed carbon dioxide to lime water, it makes it white, which is calcium carbonate. Oh, I love these questions. In a carnage, a non-metallic element X forms a pollutant Y. So, element, gaadi ke andar ek element make kar raha pollutant. And then further oxidation becomes this. Now, one mole of Y reacts with 0.5 moles of gas. Now, what can it be? Okay. First of all, aapke pollutants kon kon se hote hain? Kon se oxides pollutants hain? Carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxide and nitrogen dioxide, and sulfur dioxide, sulfur. How are all these formed? You need to know this. Carbon monoxide does not form from an element. It forms in complete combustion of a hydrocarbon. This forms from element, nitrogen in air. And this also forms from element, अगर सल्फर एज एन इम्प्योरिटी इन फ्यूल्स, तो कौन सा हम मिटा सकते हैं? ये तो है ही नहीं, ठीक है ना। अब क्या लिखा है, फर्दर ऑक्सीडेशन अकर्स स्पॉन्टेनियसली। NO कैन बिकम NO2 एंड SO2 कैन बिकम SO3, दोनों में ऑक्सीडेशन हो रही है। मसला ये है कि सिर्फ एक में स्पॉन्टेनियस है और वो है नाइट्रोजन। ये क्यों नहीं स्पॉन्टेनियस? इसके लिए आपको कैटलिस्ट चाहिए, आइदर रेडियम वाला, और इन एयर यू नीड ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ नाइट्रोजन टू ऑक्सीडाइज दिस। सो इट मस्ट नॉट बी सल्फर बिकॉज इट्स सेइंग ऑन स्पॉन्टेनियस। सो क्या, व्हाट आर द पोल्यूटेंट्स देयरफॉर? NO एंड NO2, विच मीन्स व्हाट इज द एलिमेंट? नाइट्रोजन। सो व्हाट्स नाइट्रोजन का हाइड्राइड? NH3। इज इट बेसिक? यस। इज इट इज वाई डायटॉमिक? देखो ना, अगर N इज X, देन Y इज NO एंड Z इज NO2। सो इज वाई डायटॉमिक? यस, बिकॉज देयर टू एटम्स ऑफ टू एलिमेंट्स देयर। एंड इज Z पोलर? हाउ डू आई फिगर दैट आउट? वेल, firstly it dissolves in water, so if it would not be polar, if it didn't dissolve in water, it would not be polar, it dissolves in water. And secondly, if you look at the structure of bonding, there is a pair of electron left, so it will be uneven distribution of bonds, like the lone pair effect. And I told you guys during Vesper that if you have lone pairs, then like a molecule can never be overall non-polar. The molecule will have to be overall polar, and that's why 3 is correct, which makes the answer A. Okay, now how do I apply a bond, delta H question on bond enthalpy? They're saying, what do you need to find the bond enthalpy of methane? Now, methane ke liye mujhe methane banana padega from its elements, because when you burn methane is CH4, so when you break bonds of methane, let's say I want to break all of methane bonds, what am I going to form? Let me say I want to break all of these bonds, what will I make? What type of substance do I make? If I break all of these bonds, what type of substance do I make? CH is not, it's two substances, it's C and H, or they're still bonded. I just said we're breaking bonds. They will make atoms. What state of atoms? What physical state would the atoms be in? Solid, liquid, or gas? Please, okay, what is the definition of bond enthalpy? It is the energy required to break one mole of gaseous bonds to form gaseous. So, kya banega yahan? Thank you. And where else can I make atoms from? Atomization. And atomization mein kya hota hai? You make one mole of gaseous bonds from what? From elements in the standard state. Which means carbon solid to carbon gas, that would be atomization. And hydrogen gas to hydrogen atoms, either will be atomization, all can be called bond energy. But they want to find this energy. Uske liye kya chahiye unko? Atomization of carbon, atomization of hydrogen, sorry, and this is the bond energy value. Sorry, ye nikalna hai na, sorry. So what is this then? This is element to compound. What reaction is this? Formation. Then this was similar to the previous question, so I can skip this one, right? I think that was a different mass of ethanol. Acha, isme farak kya tha? This was collected immediate distillation. That means now ethanol will make the aldehyde, which is ethanol. So the calculation will be different. It will be the MR of the ethanol, not the ethanoic acid. So I'm just going to skip this. Then, I love this question. Because people try to worry about the first line, they forget the second line. The second line is the answer. Because you work backwards from the one thing that you know, which is methyl propane. So methyl propane is a hydrogen, what will it become? Methyl propene. Methyl propene looks like this. And then that is methyl propene, that is X. Then you add two bromines. Where will you add bromines? Here and here. And then you add NaOH. What will that do? There is the Br with so you have two CH3s on a COH and then a CH2OH. There you go. D. Okay. This, look at this formula. C4H10. Kya hai? Oh, let me give you a shortcut. And that's what you need for this question, guys. If your carbon to hydrogen amount, let me repeat this. If your carbon to hydrogen amount is in the alkane ka general formula amount. Remember the alkane general formula in O-levels? CnH2n plus 2. So you have C4, how many H's does that make according to the alkane general formula? 10. 2 to the 4 is 8 plus 2, 10. Jab wo aur ye same hote hai, it means one thing and one thing only. That is, has no double bonds. What does that mean? It is not an alkene. What else is it not? What functional groups have double bonds? Aldehyde, ketones, acids. So it's not an aldehyde, ketone, or an acid. Neither an alkene. So by giving its formula, it must be an alcohol. Primary, secondary or tertiary alcohol. But primary, secondary, tertiary alcohol tolerance ka react nahi karte hai. 2,4-DNB ka react nahi karte hai. But oxidized ho sakte hai dichromate ya manganate ke saath. So kaun sa nahi hai? The question asks, which result cannot be obtained? Not which will be obtained. Only one cannot be obtained. Two can be obtained. However, tertiary alcohol will give you two. Iske baad, which pair of homologous series has the same formula in the general formula? Aldehydes and ketones. Now, either you can write the homologous series form general formulas or take a fixed number of carbons and write the formula for all of them, like two carbons or three carbons. Don't take one. It's no fun that way. Because you will have a problem because ketones mein teen carbon hone chahiye. You can't have a ketone with less than three carbons. So when I look at aldehyde ketones, aldehydes are CH3, CH2, CHO. Ketones are CH3, CO, CH3. Because they're isomers, they must have the same number of carbon hydrogen. And acids and esters also are isomers. They will also have that. Alkanes and ketones. Write a 3-carbon alkane. And write a 3-carbon ketone. That is C3H8, that is C3H6O2, and therefore that is not the case. Yeah. Oh, problem is that didn't say alkanes, that say alkenes. So, if I compare alkenes to ketones, what is an alkene for 3 carbons? C3H6. That is the same ratio as of a ketone. So, 1, 2, and 3. All is valid. Then, how many isomeric alcohols, this is a lovely question, produce an alkene that has cis trans isomers. Now, first of all, you got to figure out how many alkenes are cis trans isomers with four carbons, right? How many of them have it? I mean, ek ye option hai. Ek ye option hai. Nahi, sorry. Aur ek, this is the only alkene that will exhibit cis trans that has four carbons. That means, ab ye alkene mujhe bas kis alcohol se aaya hai? This came from what, guys? Butan-2-ol. Butane can only come from butan-2-ol, not from 1-ol. Now, how many alcohols is this? One. But the answer theoretically would not be one, it will be two. You know why? Because it's the chiral center. And a chiral center results in how many isomers? So there are two optical isomers of this structure. So how many alcohols can do this? Two. Even though that's why the question was removed, because people were confused. Okay, this is the only alcohol, butan-2-ol, that will give you butuene that will have cis trans. But butan-2-ol has optical isomers, and people don't generally count optical isomers when talking about this thing, because generally sawal mein likha hota hai structured isomers or something like that. Yahan likha hua isomeric, any isomer. So if you are going to answer to the letter of the law, the answer here is two, specific, because there are two optical isomers that will do that. Yeah. And ye bhi pehle kiya tha ispe, this was a question on earlier, I remember this from class. The idea was the nitrogen has three bonds, so must have a lone pair. So basically a double bond, a single bond, a lone pair does what? A double bond, a single bond, both behave like single bonds. So one bond and one lone pair. And lone pair is just like a bond but just a little more repulsion. So you have three bonds here, the angle should be 120, but because the lone pair, they should be a little less than 120. People assume that means, okay, let's make it 109. No. That is only possible when you have four bonds, tetrahedral. So theoretically, a little less than 120 would be 118. But 118, is it closer to 109 or 120? That's why that's the answer. Okay, last question, I'll do this one. Oh, this is also removed. Yeah. Okay. So what? This is what I will do, guys. On today, tomorrow and day after, I'm just going to record all the answers.